Audio. Cool. Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of the Esculax Hour. This is number 82, the Esculax Hour, where we bring you art, live art, and interviews, and news from Boyle Heights and locally, LA, California, anywhere close enough to us. Today we have Keeping the Culture Alive. They'll be showing up here in a few minutes right now. They're just, I think, looking for parking. So, but it's all good. They already texted me. They're on their way. As always, say what's up to Mascota Jalisco, Diego, Efren Luna, and Yeyo, which is Diego. He actually sent me a flyer. It's an artist call out in Mexico, third annual day of the musician, annual day of the musician, Santa Cecilia, and the theme is Sentimientos de Alma. For more info, it's facebook.com/elpadrinoyeyoarte. So that's how you can find out more about that artist call out. And the flyer says convocatoria de arte, tercera exposición de arte Santa Cecilia, Día del Músico, Sentimientos del Alma. It says el lugar is the place, Salón de Cabildos, Presidencia Municipal. And it says you have to the 17th of December, oh, November, 17 de noviembre, that's the deadline, el último fecha límite de registrarse. And fecha de entrega de la obra is when you gotta basically go take the art. So you have to register and then take the art. Es el 19 de noviembre, 19th of November. And I believe the address is Casa de Cultura Mascota, Calle Allende, 115, Mascota, Jalisco, Mexico. And you can find them on Facebook at Cultura Mascota. And El Padrino Yeyo Arte. No, Yeyo, he's always watching the show. Of course, I think he called earlier. And then let's say I got a text from one of our guests from Keeping the Culture Alive. I think he says they're stuck in traffic, which is, you know, it's not abnormal right here because it's Boyle Heights. Like, there's actually a Facebook page called All Roads Lead to Boyle Heights, which is like pretty much all the freeways go around here, the 10, the 60, I think the 101 or the 5, all those. So pretty much around this time it's just like packed. So right now we're just gonna, in the meantime, gonna hold that. Just kind of chill with you guys and kind of go more over what Yeyo was talking about. I don't know if you can see it a little bit. There you go. Artist call out on my phone. What else I got for you from Yeyo? The downloaded flyer. Let's see if you guys can see that. Okay. It's kind of blurry, but I'll read it off again. Tercera exposición de arte Santa Cecilia del Músico, Sentimientos del Alma. That's the name of the show. Again, it's in Salón de Cabildos, Presidente Municipal. So there's two addresses on here. I think the first one, Salón Cabildos, Presidencia Municipal, it's like where you drop it off. And then, no, you drop it off at Casa de Cultura Mascota, Calle Allende 115, Mascota, Jalisco, Mexico. That's where you drop it off. And then the show will be Salón de Cabildos, Presidencia Municipal. So I got it mixed around. And I'm pretty sure you can contact Yeyo if you're really interested. You can find him through my page, the Esculax Hour, on Facebook. And you just go to Yeyo Arte, he'll be on there. He also has a YouTube channel that he sometimes comes through and hangs out with us at the Esculax Hour. But again, thank you guys for being here another Friday. This is number 82, and we're waiting on Keeping the Culture Alive. And you guys can see the name in the There it is. Keeping the culture alive. I think that's this year. It says Dia de los Artists. It's a play on Dia de los Muertos. Dia de los Artists number 2. I'm guessing this is the second year they're doing it. October 15, 2016. And it's 4 to 9. You can actually check out their website, Keeping the Culture. I'm like the weatherman right now. It's the other way. Keeping the Culture Alive.com. All right. So check out their website. They'll be here in a few minutes. Just kind of, we're going to sit down and chat about their mission, their ideas, and why or when did they start with the, I guess you could say, organization. So we'll ask them once they get here, and let me just get seated. Whoa, I just turned tiny. I think my lighting is off a little bit. All right, as you guys can see. All right, that fixes a little bit. So we're waiting on them. In the meantime, let's recap what we did last week on the Esquilax Hour. I believe it was, who was it? Who do we have? I have a bad memory. In case you guys remember, you can hit me up on Facebook and just kind of let me know also. The one before that, it was Gerardo Mesa. He was here last week. He donated, it was last week. He donated a painting. It was like a Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump painting. That one was cool. I took that one back over there at the shop, and I'm just waiting on to take it home because I have my collection at home. And then once I have enough like artwork from all the other artists that I've met throughout the years, you know, I'll have like a little show and show them off as a private collection. Be interesting because I got like artwork from all different mediums and different types of artists, like tattoo artists, artists that work with acrylic, and some people do screen printing. I got some of those. So yeah, maybe one of these future days we'll do a little art show. Or I can bring them and show them to you guys, like a show and tell. Like I can set it up where all the, just the easels, and just kind of go through each one, where I got it. For example, the one with Chucky or Gerardo, we, you know, tell the story about it. And Chucky Mesa, see, yeah, he was watching, thanks for watching. He said, yeah, he refreshed my memory. Gerardo Mesa from Mesa Arte, he's the one that last week. And he also hooked up the audience. He hooked up Greenie because she answered the question right, which is, I think, what was his nickname? And she got it right, and then she won a painting. Today, I didn't bring a painting to give away, or I don't know what the Keeping the Culture Alive, if they're bringing like something to give away. But, you know, I think it's something we'll do here more often now that I noticed that, you know, people are into it. People want to participate in that way, where they can get a painting from the artist that's here on the show live. So we'll do that next time. And in the meantime, I'm also promoting what it's called special. I forgot what I named it. Yes, again, horrible memory. I think I actually have it. And you, Miss, I think Miss Gogo participated last week in it. It was special announcement. No, I haven't. It was in the beginning of the show. Oh, special mention, which is when you guys email me your artwork. I've actually gotten a lot of emails this week, and they're really good artists, and they're you know, I just have to go through all of them and select which one is gonna go on which show or how long I'm gonna have them on each show. Like some artists will send 5 pieces and others will, images of their artwork. And then the other ones will send like 10, 15. And then I basically either have to choose or just kind of time it where I have enough time to go through each one and just kind of shout out through to the artists that, you know, either they're too far or they're working so they can come to the show in person and like show the artwork themselves. So that's what that segment is about. It's the special mention segment, which we did last week with Miss Gogo, where she sent two of her watercolors or acrylic paintings, and then we just kind of showed them off while we waited for Chucky. And then I also painted some, it was like goblin thing. It was like a Halloween theme, like some goblins, just kind of started with it. And at the end, I did like a graph bomb around it, where I just put Sassy, which is my sister's nickname. The funny thing was nobody knew that she was coming home to visit last week. So it just worked out where I did a dedication because I missed her. And then I was like, oh, let's dedicate this piece to Sassy Cat because she's over there in school right now studying. And then out of nowhere, they hit me up and they're like, oh, she's coming. Or she was like in downtown area. So that was really... It was cool because then I showed her the piece. She was surprised because, you know, I haven't done one of those in a while, like a dedication. I did one in episode 5, I think, of where we did like, I did 3D lettering and she came on. I mean, it was her name that I did, Sassy Cat. And then I had like the mural from the alley on the other side of the studio. It was the background. That was back when we had like 1 hour and it was the Escolac hour. And Yayo was right now, he's actually saying it's called the Escolac hours because we're 2 hours on now. And right now I'm just also trying to get the tablet to work so we can kind of scroll through the different images. So let me see how we can get that to work. You guys can still hear me while I walk around. So I'm still here, don't worry. And yeah, the guys, they said they're on their way. They're stuck in traffic. Hopefully, you know, it works. Yeah, the thing is not changing.
Oh, it's not? Did you set the static in now? Oh, it's just not in the same slot anymore. I moved over.
Okay, guys, so I just checked with Nolan. He said I kind of mixed it around. I'm getting better at this while we're doing it, while the show is evolving. But in the meantime, okay. So every minute or every 60 seconds, the image will change. And Dia de los Artists 2, Art Walk. I think I saw a post about that. I think they were calling out artists too. Let me just check. You can actually find, there you go. They start flipping now. Every minute or so, keeping the culture alive. October 2000. I can't see this far. Let me see. You get a little bit closer. Boom. Suddenly I'm big again. All right, there he goes. Okay, so keeping the culture alive, the other those artists too. October 15, 4 p.m., 9 p.m. So that's actually tomorrow. So make sure you guys, if you guys want to see some dope art, go to this event. It's 137 North Montebello Boulevard. And you can get more info at keepingtheculturealive.com. Yeah. This you can see the flyer. They have Sugar Skulls, Pan de Muerto. There are more artists right there. Caught Off Guard, that's the band. It's a featured band. And again, it's tomorrow. I believe tomorrow, October 15th. Yeah. 4 p.m. to 9 p.m. So if you guys know caught off guard, that's where you can actually go catch them off guard. And yeah, more info, keeping the culture alive. The one that told me that about keeping the culture alive is Ariel Torres, or Ariel. He came like 3 episodes where we had the backdrop with like the beach. It was like the beach. And he did like a 2-hour acrylic. Yeah, it was acrylic painting of a face. He was talking about how everything just pops in his head, and that's the first thing he starts painting. I think he did a face with a dude with like a big sombrero. And that's how I started to know about keeping the culture alive from Montebello. And here you go, meet up Monday. It's a weekly sketchbook painting session. 137 North Montebello Boulevard. 6 p.m. to 9. It says right outside the Daily Brew. The Daily Brew, I don't know, it's probably a coffee shop, or it could be like a bar or something. I'm not familiar with Montebello, but pretty sure it's pretty close to Boyle Heights, like 10, 15 minutes. But not around this time, because this time is a lot of traffic. So go when it's no traffic, because it'll take you like 2 hours. It says meet up Monday. And it's a weekly sketchbook. I don't know if they have live models, because I know Israel Martinez, when he does like, what do you call it? Huh? Yeah, if it's them, yeah. So they just arrived, and like I was saying, traffic is a pain in the butt. And you can see, I believe that's Ariel, dude serving that guy, yeah. It's Ariel or Ariel. They're actually making like paper mache, or they're making like some kind of sign work, but it's not food. I just misunderstood that photo. So in the meantime, they set up, I'm just gonna keep telling you guys about the images. And I'm just telling them that one of them dudes needs to sign one of the waivers. All right. So as we wait, well, there you go. It's, I don't know who busted this one. Let me move out the way. It's somebody doing a cartwheel. I can't read it, but it says Art Fest 2016, an event either they had already or they're going to have again. I'm pretty sure it was like a summer event because it just seems like it's a lot of light. So, unless it was the one like a month ago. But hopefully they'll come on right now and they'll explain more to you guys. You know me, I'm always trying to guess what the flyer, what's behind the artwork, but then like most of the time I get it like half wrong. So, my bad. And on the side, you can, you guys see these? Pretty sure you can, if you go on their website, keepingtheculturealive.com, they have more of those. And that's like a booth at an event. Oh no, that's their, the sketchbook thing, the flyer, 2 photos before. So Ariel is here today again, and I think they brought, they're gonna do some art, but they still have to kind of sign up. I mean, not sign up, set up. You guys can tell today I didn't drink my espresso, and I'm just kind of feeling it right now. You see that? No coffee yet in my system. I'm pretty sure you can notice in some of the episodes I'm all jittery, I'm all kind of, you know. And so yeah, they're here just waiting for them to come on camera. And there you go. Oh, that's the Virgen de Guadalupe. March, I believe so. March Lupe. What's up, man?
What's going on, dude?
All right, yeah. So you guys remember Ariel? We're using that camera right now. You guys want to get closer right here?
How's it going?
There you go. And what was your name again?
Rick?
Yeah, how's it going?
Good. So Rick and Ariel, keeping the culture alive. I was mentioning they brought the flyers for the events that are coming up, or you guys, the events that you guys did?
Those are the flyers for the event that's coming up tomorrow.
Yeah, the Dia de los Artists, too, right? Oh, yeah. I don't know if they're able to listen.
In your pocket. Oh, okay.
So we're going to get some audio. You guys might have been able to hear them from there. From here.
Probably.
But they're going to get their audio on right now. So. Thanks to Nolan. Nolan's old. Yeah, I put on this one. Yeah, it's this one. Okay. Yeah. Because I didn't want to mess with that one.
Awesome.
The green light?
Now we're...
Green light?
All right. Yeah, green light.
Green light.
All right, green light. So today you guys are going to tell us a little about keeping the culture alive. Yeah. And are you also going to do some painting? Or?
Yeah, we're going to be doing some painting.
Yeah, we're here to do that.
Okay. So yeah, you. How long do you guys want to do some or who's going to paint?
We're going to do a collab piece on it.
Just let me know what you guys need right now, because I mean... do you need the easel?
I think we're going to need that. Because the canvas is a bit big, so we're probably going to need that easel that
we'll
you had last time.
Yep. Again, I was telling Ariel, he knows everything is live, everything is, you know,
awesome.
Raw. We're
uncut.
On dronebox.com.
Uncut.
Uncut. So.
You edit me, make me look a little thinner. Yeah. Just kidding, man.
And if you want to go take a seat and then talk a little bit about keeping the culture.
Oh, sweet.
All right, so Ariel, and what was his name again?
Rick.
Rick. I always gotta tell people how bad I'm with the
name.
Right, no, last time I was on, you called me Daniel, right?
Yeah, right after I told him, like, oh, you know, his name is Ariel, and when I go into the camera, I'm like, oh, this is Daniel. So Rick.
Right after he asked me, like, what's your name?
He's
like,
I'll go by Omni-Chang.
Omni-Chang?
Omni,
it's
fine.
What does it mean?
It's just basically an old alias I used to work with.
Old alias, we all have them, like me, the Esquilax.
Yeah.
Old alias.
I still don't.
You still don't?
I'm not cool yet.
We gotta give you one.
Yeah.
We'll start calling you Daniel.
Daniel, there you go. Daniel.
That's going by Daniel.
So I was just going through the photos. I mean, right now the tablet's kind of messed up, so it's just changing every minute or so.
Okay,
you can see in the monitor.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You want to tell us a little bit, like, what's going on with keeping the culture alive right now, like this year? How's it been?
Yeah.
You guys been staying busy?
Definitely staying busy. We just had our big annual art fest that we do. We do one every year. It's a big event we do at the Montebello City Park. We just finished that one last month. We had about 135, 140 vendors.
Yeah.
We had food trucks, live music, lots of different events going on, lots of different things like that.
I think that's the one you were mentioning, right? You mentioned it that time?
Yeah.
It was like a week before?
Yeah, and it was a huge, I want to call it a huge success, because actually ended up with, we ended up with a lot more vendors than we anticipated.
Yeah.
We were trying to cap it, right? We were trying to cap it at 170 or so.
No,
or what was it?
Well, no. Last year we had too many. This year we had to cap it at about. We wanted to cap it at about 120 vendors.
Mm-hmm.
We ended up having about 100 and I want to say 137.
137.
Like that.
Yeah, that's a lot.
It is a lot. Yeah.
And that means there's a lot of people going by too, right?
There's a lot of foot traffic. We expected. We think about close to anywhere between 800 to 1,000.
That's a lot of people.
So it was
that's a good event.
It was an awesome event.
It was free, right?
Yeah, it was a free event.
Free event.
We had over like 14 different live performances,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Both bands and single performers. They were awesome too. I mean,
yeah.
Coming from as far as San Diego.
Hemet.
So, Hemet, yeah. So they did some traveling to come down to the show. Yeah. You know?
And people were doing live art, right? Of course.
Live art.
Yeah. It was funny because one of my friends, I think she actually did live art. Her name was, her name is Jade. She goes by R2Jade on Instagram.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah, I was like, whoa, I didn't even know she was there painting. Yeah.
Yeah, it's funny how many people pop up here. And I was just telling Randy that a couple weeks ago, I was in, not even a couple weeks, maybe about a week ago, I was in Whittier and I was walking down the street and I had this shirt on.
Yeah.
And some lady on the street pulls up to the corner. That was a great show. And I didn't know what she was talking about at first. I'm like, what? And she's like, your show at the park. And I was like, oh yeah, well thanks, you know. So that's it's really cool that we're reaching out all over and people are recognizing us now, you know, for what we are. We've been doing it for about 3 years.
Three years.
Like I said, this was our third annual one, and I think now we're starting to become almost a household name. You know what I mean? We at least in Montebello
and
surrounding cities. So.
Yeah, and we're actually extending now too. Mm-hmm. So we're going to be extending out into the Pico Rivera area too.
That's good.
You know, we're trying to expand as much as we can. You know, so
that's good.
It's awesome. Yeah.
Especially because you said what it's about, what keeping the culture alive. You know.
Yeah, man. We're trying to keep that alive and the art too. You know, like the art culture. Is a big part of it, you know.
And I was also seeing that it was like it's like a sketch session or that you guys do every Monday.
Yeah, the flyer for the meetup Monday.
Yeah, meetup.
That's a new thing that we just started. It's just supposed to be something to encourage people that are like on the fence of whether or not they want to like, you know, participate in these kind of art events.
Yeah.
You know? I told them before, or right when I joined, I told them, Randy and Rick, I was like, man, you know, before I joined you guys, I would look up online and just see if people were getting together just to do a session, you know. So having this is awesome because we get to meet possibly new people that are interested in signing up, or even if they're just like art, you know, they can just come down and chill with us and like, you know.
And we've been doing it ourselves for, you know, every time we have a meeting, we meet up at a local place, you know. A lot of times it's the Daily Brew coffee shop in Montebello.
Oh, it's a coffee shop? I was telling the audience, I don't know if it's a coffee shop or it was a bar.
It's the Daily Brew. It's a coffee shop. That's where we do our monthly events. So we feel at home there, you know what I mean? So we meet up there, you know, once a week, you know, if we can, twice a week, to just to go over what we're doing next, you know what I mean? What events are coming up next? You know, where can we advertise our event? Where can we promote our event? And since we started doing that, we started saying, hey, let's invite other people to come just so we can draw and then do stuff like that. So we had the first one,
about two weeks ago, I think.
And we thought, okay, we'll just put it on Facebook and see how it goes, kind of thing, you know. So we put it on social media, and for a minute we thought it was just going to be the three of us, and my sister's part of the organization too. She's, you know, but she's a little more preoccupied. She has a big family,
of course,
and she's the mother, you know. So she's a little preoccupied with stuff, but she came down and she brought her two of her boys.
Yeah.
And they came and they hung out with us, and then a couple of other artists.
Some other people
popped up, and we're like, "Hey,
Usually, when you do it the first time, you're like, "Eh,
it's gonna be, no one's gonna be here." Yeah. You know, but it was cool. We had a little group.
We had
put the little tables together, so we got little things. So we decided, you know what? We're gonna start doing this more often, and we're gonna start doing little chat. We did a little challenge, you know. We said, draw your favorite superhero.
So make it fun.
So everybody drew a superhero. The next week we'll do, you know, the
different theme.
We'll pick like a theme and then like do a challenge to that theme.
How long are you guys there for?
We're usually there from 6 to like 9.
6 to 9?
Usually.
That's a good time. Yeah, that's a good time.
We always say we'll meet up for like an hour or something.
And it ends up being like 3 hours.
Because you get into it.
It's a lot of fun though.
It's fun. It's just chill, you know. You get there. It doesn't matter if they're all different type of skill levels.
Yeah.
So that doesn't matter. It's just something fun, you know.
Yeah.
And that's the thing is that because our organization is, it's an art organization founded by artists. There's no commercial organization, you know, running the show.
Or like politics.
There's nobody in the politics. There's nobody in the you know, there's none of that corporate agenda pushing us in a certain direction.
Yeah,
like, we are a collective, you know, we're artists. We are local artists that are doing
it's like he said, he was looking for a spot where, you know, you could just go and just kind of do your thing as an artist, like draw or just kind of exchange ideas.
Exactly, yeah.
And, you know, this is what you found, right?
Yeah,
because they already had it going, right? And then you found them.
Exactly. I mean, they already had the art wall going and everything. And luckily, I came into the group right when they were just looking to expand more. Yeah. I mean, they were already expanded, but, you know, just looking to do more things.
Yeah.
So I came at an awesome time. You know, to see everything start coming together, because now we're getting more recognized, our events are getting more people, and now that we're doing little things like this, then it's great. It's just catching more people's attention, so that's awesome. And also bringing them something and some place to go to do,
and also
you know what they want to do.
You know that you're doing something positive too,
especially
for that community, the Montebello community.
Exactly.
And now you're expanding into, you know, Pico Rivera, right?
Yeah.
And
And
I personally never been out there, so I don't know how art is doing out there. Like, I don't know if they
have. That's the thing. That's another thing, is that there's no real venue for it. I mean, there's no events like that in that area. The Whittier has a big one once a year. They have their Day of the Dead event, the Dia de los Muertos. Other than that, they don't have much like that.
Yeah.
East LA always has something
going on. Yeah, East LA, Boyle Heights.
Los Angeles, the downtown.
The downtown, that's the one
everybody knows. So for people to get that kind of culture, they have to travel out there, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And we don't have that going towards the east side unless you go all the way to Riverside.
The Riverside.
You know what I mean? So there's a big gap in between. Montebello doesn't have that. Pico Rivera doesn't have that. So that's what we want to do. We want to make that. We want to be the people to bring that, you know what I mean?
That's good, you're taking this step.
Because honestly, like, families and kids, and they don't have that. They don't have that locally to them, you know what I mean? So we want to make sure that they have access to that in that area.
You know, when they're not around it, it's like they don't.
And right now there's no charge, right? It's like, unless there's like a venue or something involved.
People to come and, no, there's no charge. We have our events. Like, for instance, our Dia de los Artists tomorrow, there's no charge for the people to come. They come, they could see all of our art. There's going to be a band performing. There's going to be music throughout the whole thing.
Yeah.
There's going to be a band performing, Caught Off Guard. They're going to perform. There's, you know, there's a coffee shop. There's we're bringing people to that area too. There's places to eat. There's, you know, places to hang out. And you could just chill, you know what I mean?
Because growing up, when I grew up in an area where, you know, there weren't a lot of Latinos, or, you know, I'm Mexican, so there were some. But I know, I felt that if I wanted to go see art, or if I wanted to show my art, I would always have to either pay a fee. Like, I was young, I was like, I don't know, 16, 15, you know, and I had that in my head, like, oh, you know, every time I want to show my stuff, or every time, there's no organization, like, you know. Back then, I didn't know about any that, you know, keeping the culture alive, where they would just let you go and, you know, draw with people, or let you go and show your art and participate without.
Well, for our events, we do have a fee for the spot.
For like
that's what I said, like the venues, of course.
But for the meetups, when we meet up and hang out and we sketch and there's no fee for that.
Yeah, because exactly, because I know a couple of them, and they're all like, you know, $15, $25 to go.
But you do that, and it takes away from what we're trying to represent.
Yeah,
we're trying to kind of stay away from the business end of it. I mean, obviously, there is business involved into it, but we're not. That's not like a focus.
Yeah,
you know? We're just trying to bring art to people, bring an environment where people can come together and appreciate art and make art, you know, because it's like Rick said, it's only LA, like the major LA area, and then a huge gap, and then Inland Empire, right?
Yeah.
In between, it's like people have to travel to either end to go go appreciate art. So we're trying to bring it to people here, you know, and expand and you know, just bring it to them. You know, that's pretty much.
It makes sense.
And really get across our message of just exactly that, keeping the culture alive, keeping the arts alive. You know, I mean, it's honestly starting to die in a lot of places. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Schools are already talking about, you know,
yeah, they got rid of the
cutting fundings. That's the first
funding,
thing.
Yeah, that's art class, one of the main
music,
things.
You know what I mean? Those are the first things to go.
Yep.
And that's definitely something we don't need in this already hectic country. You know what I mean?
That's something that's like we can't afford to lose.
Yeah. And if we don't have outlets outside of school, you know what I mean? If we don't have those outlets for the kids, you know, or that that inspiring factor coming in, then they're not going to get it anywhere. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
So we have to keep that in the public eye. We have to keep that in the public's hands. You know what I mean? So they have access to it whenever they need it.
It has a very positive effect too. Yeah. I mean, a very positive outcome. When we had our art fest, I told you that we're going to have like we did a workshop for the kids.
Yeah.
And that was awesome. I mean, we had a bunch of kids, all sorts of different ages, doing this workshop.
Everywhere from three and four up to like 16, you know. I saw some teenagers.
Yeah, so they were pretty inspired.
Yeah, and they were out there painting.
It's fun to get their hands dirty, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and they're all happy, you know, leaving with their pieces that they've made, and it was all free, you know.
Even walking around with them trying to sell
Yeah,
it was so funny, right?
It was cool,
It was
cool. They were having fun. They were just kids.
It was fun, though, and it was, and again, it was free, you know what I mean?
So it's good to see that.
Get your kids out there to do
that. Exactly, it's a good feeling to see that families don't have to travel far. They could just go to a local event and have that kind of interaction, you know, and see that, you know, art is actually, you know, something to do. It's really good. And it's creative. It makes you feel good, you know,
because
people don't know that. Like people that aren't exposed or don't really grow up around an art driven like society or an environment, they just don't get it. They don't.
Yeah, no, they won't.
Yeah. So that's what we got to do, is bring it to them and say, hey, you know, this is, you know, this is important. This is like,
especially the kids,
your culture. This is your, you know, your expression. This is being a human being, you know? Pretty much. You look at the world nowadays. It's like everybody's on their phone.
Yeah.
You know, nobody's doing anything creative. You think you're doing something creative, but you're just on your phone. You know,
it's a system.
Yeah, and it's like, really, come on, dude. You got to get out there and do it.
Catching,
you know, like,
Pokemon.
Yeah, learn how to. Get your hands dirty, you know, like, instead of going to, instead of going out catching Pokemon.
So I hate on that. I know.
No, everybody.
It's fun, but it's still like, it's like, you gotta, you know.
But some of them, that's all they know.
Yeah.
Like, that's, they don't.
Exactly. You gotta balance it out at least and tell them, like, hey,
exactly. They won't write a poem. They won't draw like a sketch.
Exactly.
And that's all they know.
Bring that up too. You said write a poem. Is that when we talk about keeping the culture alive, we talk about all of the cultural arts. We talk about writing poetry.
Exactly.
We talk about making music. You know, we talk about all of that. And that's kind of what we're trying to do, you know? Like, that's why we always like to have live performances at our events, because we want to promote the music, the art of making the music. You know, mind you, don't take away from the DJs and stuff like that, because I love that art too. But you know what I mean? We always try to have the live performances.
Just self-expression.
We've had people come up there. We've had MCs come up, do their little freestyles.
We've had poets.
We've had poets come up and
poetry.
Stuff. You know, we like that. That's what we want.
Yeah.
We want our organization to be rich with that. You know what I mean? So
it's not just, you know, prone to one thing, like just paint,
just
and
painting,
and no, it's, you know, we embrace all sorts of art.
We do, and we have artists that do all kinds of different things. We have, I mean, we have our canvas painters. You know, I myself, I do canvases. I dabble in wood burning. This guy does pretty much anything you put in front of him, he'll do it. But we have people who make jewelry. We have people that make
definitely
multimedia pieces. You know what I mean? Where it's like prints and acrylics on top of that, and so on and so. We got people to do, you know, boxes and I mean,
just
it,
all
it's
sorts.
Really
so,
a lot of
like, we have
an
performance art. Have you guys ever had people do?
We've never had performance art, but we've never ruled it out either. We actually, there was a small theater group in Montebello that we were working with, but unfortunately, they closed up shop. So, but that was we were hoping to really band together and, you know, do things together. But unfortunately, it didn't work out for us. But I would love to do that. I did theater in my early 20s, it was a lot
my
of
heyday.
Yeah. Oh, I really loved it a lot. But then, you know, again, you move on with life. I have kids and you know, I had to work.
Things
and
change.
It just gobbles all your time up and everything like that. So I had to leave all that behind. But so when we started working with this theater company, I got really excited again. I was like, oh, I'm taking me back to my 20s. But no, but I would love to do that again. I would love to get involved with that and have them get involved with us. And I think that would be great.
Yeah. Like, we wouldn't turn that down.
If anybody wants to work with us, you know what I mean? You know,
performing arts, we're open to that.
Arts, yeah.
We won't turn you away.
Websites.
I used to do, my favorite thing to do were improv shows.
Yeah.
I still like doing improv shows. Like doing improv shows with my kids. They don't understand what I'm doing.
No, definitely. I mean, as you said, you haven't had it, right? That's like, but it's not ruled out.
Definitely not ruled out. Yeah, we're always open to new venues. We're always open to new working with different people because we want this to grow. You know what I mean? We love being Montebello based. But
of course
because we all, not him, he's an outsider. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. But we're from there. We're from Montebello.
Yeah.
And so that's our that's home to us. You know what I mean? But we definitely want to grow outside. We want KTCA. We want keeping the culture alive to reach all over. You know what I mean?
We're already in Texas.
Yeah, we do have a branch of KTCA, keeping the culture alive in Helotes, Texas.
Yeah.
We have a friend of ours that is part of our organization that moved there.
What is his name? Or
His name is Pedro. Forgive me, Pedro. I cannot remember your last name.
Pedro? Shout out to
Pedro.
And
I don't know it, so sorry.
It was before you.
I don't know it.
He does have his own YouTube channel, and he's going to kill me right now if he sees this and I don't remember what it is. So, but maybe we can get a link somewhere. Anyway, but he runs the Keeping the Culture Alive in Texas. He moved out there before, I think it was like last year sometime.
So, he
does that out there.
That's good that, you know, you have artists out there already working on this.
Yeah. So we're always trying to branch out, make something bigger. Hopefully we have.
What should people do or artists do if they want to, like, let's say they're in another state and they want to get linked up with you guys?
They can contact us. Yeah. Our website is keepingtheculturealive.com. Email us. You can email us at ktcalive@gmail.com. So it's ktcalive@gmail.com. You could just give us a pitch. Tell us what you wanted to do, what your ideas are. If you're, you know, in a different state, different city, different country. let us know.
Yeah, they put it on the screen. KTC.
Yeah, look at that. Perfect. Yeah, so there we are going to be, we're always trying to reach out and get bigger and get bigger and badder, you know what I mean? But that's what we want. We want this to grow as big as it can. And we want people with our same visions in mind, you know what I mean? People that are thinking about the arts.
Spreading them.
We don't want to get too caught up in the business where it's like, oh, well, this is for money and that is, no. Like, we need that to move along, but our focus is,
of course,
keeping the cultural arts alive. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So definitely.
That's right.
Definitely.
So. There you go, guys. So. Keeping the culture alive today on the Escolax Hour, episode 82 with Rick and Daniel.
And Daniel.
Ariel.
They're gonna know.
And thank you guys for tuning in. And right now we're just kind of learning about keeping the culture alive.
Yeah, Randy, our president, was gonna join us today, but
what's up, Randy?
They're
here.
Unfortunately, he's under the weather, feeling under the weather.
Yeah, no worries.
Couldn't make it, but yeah,
it's all
so
good.
We're here.
Things happen.
On his behalf.
Yep, we're here.
Sending Randy.
Behalf.
Do you guys want to say hi to anybody that's watching, or just later on when we upload it, you can say.
Man, you guys all suck for not being here. No, I'm just kidding.
Nobody was able to
make
it.
No, but big thanks to, you know, to Randy, of course, for making this all happen. Randy is the one who started this.
Yep.
Yeah, he's the one who started this. He's the one that had the vision, I guess, that we all had, but put it in motion.
Put it in motion.
So he actually, I met Randy about 3 years ago, maybe a little over 3 years ago. Yeah, it must have been a little over 4 years ago. And we started working with him to get the ball rolling on this stuff. So, shout out to Randy, of course, for making this all start. And everybody else who's been involved, you know, I mean, there's a lot of people that have helped us along the way, and
a lot of people in the group. So everybody in the group.
Yeah.
All the supporters.
Everybody in the group.
Jennifer, Joanne, who else?
And the, you said
Pedro, Street Rebirth.
You guys do it at City Brew? What's it called?
The Daily Brew.
Daily Brew.
Shout out to the Daily Brew
for letting us do that.
The Daily Brew coffee shop. You can find them on Instagram, Facebook, all that stuff. They're in Montebello.
Off of Montebello Boulevard.
So yeah, Montebello in Cleveland, one block north of Whittier Boulevard.
So. Shout out to Cut Off Guard, I think. They're going to be there tomorrow.
Cut Off Guard will be there tomorrow.
For doing it, for the Formula, for being our resident DJ.
Formula.
I'm terrible at this stuff.
No, it's the camera. It's the camera. It makes you forget.
But yeah, so I think that's a lot of people. So.
Yeah, that's the good thing is like we have a good big team that they all have their attributes, man. Everybody puts chips in, so it's really cool.
A lot of people
handle a lot of different things. So
and after this the event for tomorrow, what do you guys have planned next? Is there anything, or is it just like as you're going?
I don't know. We do the artist corner every third month. Saturday.
Mm-hmm. Every third Saturday.
So it's every month. Tomorrow is the Dia de los Artists, which is, you know, the day of the event. Yeah, it's the day of the event from 4 to 9. And then the following month.
Our weekly event, which is going to be the Meetup Monday.
The Meetup Monday.
And that's all the info event. Right there. The address is right there on the screen. And it's really hard to miss us. I mean, once you get there, just look for the big guy. You'll see us in a big group, you know. Yeah. So it's
right on the corner. So
hard to miss.
And we're always outdoors.
And you say different skill levels too. So
Don't be afraid.
That's why I said my sister brought her kids.
Yeah.
They were there. They're one's 11, one's 15. You know. So
yeah. Nobody's there to criticize or anything. It's just all.
We're not there to do anything like that. We're just there to have fun.
Yeah. To just
doodle away and. Yep. And see what, you know, it's really cool to look at what everybody brings to the table. You know?
And then, like,
and you actually get tips, like, from
other artists. That's what I was going to say.
Exchange info.
It's a way to kind of improve off of one another and stuff.
Talking about, like, hey, what do you think about this? Or, hey, how do you do that? You know, I'm always working. Art, DCA Toys, we can't leave out.
Oh, DCA Toys,
That guy, too. DCA Toys, great guy. He's helped us a lot as well. You know, he's given us a lot of pointers and stuff like that. So a lot of great guys have always come through, and that's the thing, like with this organization, is that we have a lot of loyalty to each other, you know what I mean? We keep our circle pretty tight as far as, you know, what we share, and we love to just, you know, we like to keep the artists that we deal with are very they're loyal people, you know what I mean? We're all in it for the same
They keep
cause.
Their word.
A lot of it's on the honor system, you know what I mean? When we talk to each other, we don't try and we don't have to worry about people stealing our ideas or people taking what
we have,
you know what I mean? Or copying or anything. Because we're all on the same page. We're all just artists. We're all in the same boat, you know?
Yeah.
Just trying to do what we do and feel the love for that.
Yeah,
you know?
And it's hard to find others like that too.
Yeah,
especially
yeah.
nowadays.
And that's why I feel great that we have a circle that does that, you know, that is like that. So there's a lot of people that help us out and I think that's a great thing. So
nice. That's good. Keeping the culture alive, again, it's not just painting,
it's everything.
It's everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if you're in the area and you've always been looking for a place to come down and hang out and draw or do what you do. You
can
know.
We get the cheers playing right now? Everybody knows
your name. Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah. So if you guys want to, if everybody wants to follow us, you know, Ariel, what's your Instagram?
My Instagram is art_by_ArielT. So.
Yeah, no, we'll also link it up when we do the Instagram posts and the
YouTube. I mean, you can literally like follow any one of us
I'll tag you guys.
Any questions, you know, have them message us, no problem.
We're always looking for new people to work with, new supporters, you know. We like to work with a lot of different types of people and really get you know, like I said, get our name out there.
And you're under
Omni Chang Designs.
Right?
Yeah, Omni Chang Designs, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. What else do I have?
There's actually a KTCA Instagram, right?
Yeah. Keeping the culture alive. Is just that, keeping the culture alive. You can find that all on, again, all media outlets, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. All of those are great ways to get in contact with any of us. It was Pedro has a YouTube account. I don't know if the Keeping the Culture Alive YouTube account is active. Oh, ready for my close up. Hang on, it's getting rough. I'm not sure if the Keeping the Culture Alive YouTube account is up and active yet, but
testing.
We are always active on other social media outlets. We're always active on Instagram, always active on Facebook, constantly active on Facebook. We do have live feeds coming through when we can.
And I just remembered the question that he asked us earlier. After the Dia de los Artistas show tomorrow, we have we will have a booth at the
Montebello Pet Fair,
October 22nd,
the Montebello Pet Fair, just outside of the hangar in Montebello.
KTCA will have a booth there.
Yes, we'll be there.
So that's the next event after
The Dia de los Artistas.
The Dia de los Artistas.
Yeah. And then, of course, whatever comes up, we always keep our schedule open to other events that might be happening. We always try and get aboard with other art walks, you know, in the communities and so on and so forth.
All right, cool. So you guys got to learn a little bit more about Keeping the Culture, because, you know, Ariel came last time and told a little bit, but now we went more deep into it, how it's from Montebello. It's a project or an organization that's growing. They're now in Texas also. Mm-hmm. And
expanding into Pico Rivera.
Expanding to Pico Rivera.
And hopefully Whittier too.
Whittier and, too, probably.
They have events where, you know, some of them, you know, they're free to go and sketch, go hang out, learn from other artists, mainly in Montebello. Mm-hmm. And you said Daily Brew.
The Daily Brew,
where you can find Rick and Ariel. And right now they said they're gonna do some live art for us, so we're gonna get set up. As it's gonna take us a few minutes, and you guys can watch live. Yep. And if you guys are watching from
Facebook Live,
Live, go ahead. And you said from yours, they're gonna
Well,
we got like a little stand, and they
I got a little clip-on stand.
Okay.
That we can put up.
There you go. You guys under Omni Chang.
Yeah. Under look at me. It might Rick Via Omni Chang Designs. Should be able to find it both on those.
Okay, so we're gonna set up and you guys can kind of.
Right on.
How's that?
Where are we setting this up?
All right, guys, it's just me pushing a desk. You guys wanna con el sillón? ¿Cómo se llama? Sillón o sofá? Something. Let's go this way. And yeah, your mics are, I believe they're still live. So if you guys. Huh? No, but I can do it. All right.
I know mine's on.
Yeah. Oh, you turned it off? Okay. Oh, you guys can still hear me. All right. right, so this thing is
this,
yeah, I was just last show I was painting. I was telling the audience that. Oh, this way.
This way?
That one. Oh, you just set it up there. All right, guys, you guys can still hear me. We're setting up. We're just kind of chatting. Ah, cuidado. And the light. All right, you guys know we're at dronebox.com right now. You guys can see Ariel on the screen. And you guys are gonna put it on it, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. I can take this off if you guys. You guys need the background or just?
It doesn't matter. If you want to take it off or leave it, it doesn't matter.
I think we could just leave it if it doesn't bother you guys.
Yeah, I'll be back.
All right. Alright guys, thank you guys again for watching. I'm gonna open the back door and you guys can hear it. So we can air it out, and you can see Ariel right now on the, he's posting the canvas, and Rick is helping them. They're actually clamping it. It's a first for Escolax Hour, which is cool. The more creative you get, the better. Hey, that's me, I'm under. Hey, what's up guys? You can clamp it to a chair or.
I know, but I somewhere along the line.
Yeah. Okay, so we're going into our second hour of the Escolax Hour. Damn. Again, we're raw, uncut. Set up. For that one?
For my phone, so it doesn't die.
Yeah, I think I could get one. All right, we got some KTCA action going. Just don't trip on the cord. We'll be right here. All right, guys, 4:59, when we're heading into the second hour of the Escolax Hour, 82. And if I said a different number earlier, whoops. And we're here today with KTCA, Keeping the Culture Alive, Gmail, from Montebello. And you guys just kind of, you know, don't go all crazy. Gotta take care of the green screen. Other than that, you guys are good to go.